Hello and welcome back to part two of my How to Be a New Player in City of Heroes. We're here with the Running Man, and I'm going to get you kind of to a quick start here as you start playing the game. First off, your map is very important, and it's usually connected right here in the middle when you first press the map. But you can press these little blue buttons to unanchor stuff and then slide them around. I should keep my map over here. You can zoom in. You use a sliding bar and zoom in on stuff. And you will find that we have lots of important people here, including this very important one we're going to visit next is the P2W vendor. And if you click on that, it'll show you right where that person's at, which happens to be right over here. Now, the P2W, or pay-to-win vendor, has a lot of items that NCSoft used to sell through a cash shop or give you for multiple months of subscription. And there's a lot of cool things to help get our character to an early start. So we're going to jump in to a couple of things here. So the first thing you want to get is these prestige enhancements. You can only use one of each of these. You can only equip one of each of these. And for those who don't know, enhancements are like gear for your character. They help your character's powers to be more effective. And if we go into manage our enhancements in the lower right-hand corner, for those who didn't see, I'll do that again. In the lower hand corner, there's a button that's called Enhancements. Click on that, and then click on the word Manage here. And you'll see I have my fist attack there, and you can pull this red thing over here. If you hold it down, it'll show you that the damage is going to go up, as well as the recharge time will improve. Okay, but that's the only power we have right now, so we're going to equip that guy in there. Now, there's other things we can get from this lady that'll be very helpful for no money at all. And we're a new character, we're broke. One is we can go to prestige powers here. We go to attacks, and you want to go about a halfway down, and there's different attacks you can pick from here. You can read through those, but there's essentially six, and you get to pick three, though you can't pick two of the same thing. So I'm just going to quick. This is a melee character, so I'm going to claim one more melee attack and a couple of ranged attacks to the staff and the black one are ranged attacks. Now these attacks are good for beginning characters. These were specifically designed to help make the leveling process a bit easier when you have few powers to play around with. So we're going to take those. We're going to show you how to equip those in a minute, so don't worry about that. We can also get a pet that provides this little extra buff. It says the first one's free. So I'm going to grab one of these little pets as well. We have travel, and what we're looking for is movement. This is faster movement to help us get around the world faster. There's different kinds. There's beast run, makes you look like you're a beast running on the ground. And the first one of these is free as well. I'm going to go with ninja. The guy's going to look like a ninja while he's running around. Now you can take a look at these other things. There's some other things, and some of these are free, like jumps and stuff. But the ones I'm showing you are the ones that I tend to get on every single character without even thinking twice. Then under utility, we have inner inspiration. This gives you free inspirations every 30 minutes, big ones. We'll go ahead and grab that because that's free. And inspirations, for those who don't know, are consumable items. We're going to play around with those a little bit later. But this gives you three free runs every 30 minutes, which is very handy. Let's see. I think I got that guy there. All right, the next, now some of these cost money. You'll be coming back and buying some cool things later, but right now we're looking for stuff for new players. The next big thing you always want to make sure you get on your characters are experience boosters. This will add another 100% to your experience gain. If you're playing a reunion, you already got 100% boost. This will give you another 100% boost for 1 hour for each time you hit the buy button. It's free. You can buy this up to 8 hours worth at a time. Now, the trade-off is you will not gain influence while you're doing this, which is the currency. But that's okay because I got another video where I will show you how to make a lot of money that really eclipses anything you would make by what the bad guys drop when you defeat them. So go ahead and grab those if you want to level quickly. If you want to level slowly, don't worry about it. It's not a big deal and whatnot. Later on, I will say one of the first things I tend to buy after I get a little bit of money is the travel flight pack that will help you fly around, and you can get this after you do your first story arc. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. Now that we've got all these new powers, we need to equip them. If you click on powers, You'll see here in the lower right-hand corner, well, my face is, I'll move that up a little bit. You'll see in the lower right-hand corner, the small text, we have these different powers. You're looking for those like Sands of News and things like that that we got. And you can start dragging those down to your toolbar. Now the toolbar only has 10 slots. We can get more by hitting the little up arrow that's in the lower right-hand corner. Now that gives us duplicates of toolbar number one, but if we hit the arrows on the right here, we can have the toolbar number two and three, and now we have three times as many slots. So we can go ahead and drag those new attacks into slots. Our new drone pet that we got, we can drag that in. And our ninja run, we want to put that guy in there somewhere. And now we're good to go. Now the first thing I tend to do after doing that is just get level two really quick. I got new attacks to do that now. I got ninja run. And if I just, here's Lady Liberty again for reference. And if you just go to the south right here, there's usually a few bad guys I can beat up on really, really quick. So I'm gonna go and just beat up on some bad guys. Jeez, that's a lot of bad guys to beat up on at once. They're not usually clumped together this bad. So hopefully I don't get my butt royally kicked here. The running man would be very unhappy if he died during the video. But it wouldn't be the first time, I'll be honest. That bad guy is down. You probably should avoid clumps like that, but really I just need to beat three or four guys and I get that next level up real quick. And now with my ninja run, I'll run over here to the trainer lady and go ahead and get my level two power. So when you level up, you kind of level up automatically, but you got to come back to the trainer and every even number level, you'll pick a new power. And then every odd number level, you will get more enhancement slots to allocate for gear. As right now, my powers only have one enhancement slot. Since I picked up a new offensive power, I can take these red enhancements are for offensive powers. I can put that in there and make that a little bit better. And that's really it for. Oh no, one more thing I'll show you before I leave. So in order to make money, you need to do story arcs, which coincidentally help you to level up. My recommendation usually is to come do Matthew's story arc first. He's usually right here. He's very easy to get to. You can talk to him. And when we say a story arc, what that means is when you take a mission from a contact, so you say, hey, I'm going to accept this message. I'll go help these people. He'll send you on your way. So you go and you defeat these five hellions. You come, and then when you're done, he'll say, return to the contact at the top, which means you got to come back here to Matthew. Come back here, turn it in, and he'll give you another one. And then another one. After like three to five of these, maybe seven sometimes, he'll say, okay, you're done. Great job. And here's a new contact. Usually when you do these things, they will give you what's called merit rewards. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to turn those merit rewards into cold hard cash that will eclipse anything you're going to get from these, from just the things that bad guys drop anytime soon. So I'll see you in the next video. Take care.